بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Thank you for allowing me to present my paper. It's about prototype development of traffic calming solution to replacing speed hump to non-Newtonian foot speed hump. Okay, so this is presentation for International Conference on Education, Humanities and Technology Research. Okay, as an introduction, development of traffic calming usually is to reduce current traffic or related problem. Okay, according to Zalewski and also Nushamna. Okay, traffic authorities conclude this speed hump effectively to measure to solve various type of traffic issue, such as overspeeding, high volume through traffic, road traffic accident, and pedestrian safety. Okay. speed hump as well. It's possible to increase the traffic noise pollution, congestion, or vehicle damage. Therefore, the non-Newtonic fleet speed hump is developed. That's why we're going to replace that noise pollution or traffic pollution because of the speed hump into the new method development of a non-Newtonic fleet speed hump. It's a cost effective and work as efficiently, so this eco-friendly and economic friendly to the society as well. As a problem statement, it is reported by police, Royal Malaysian Police in 2008, it's about 548,000 cases road accidents happened in just one in 2018. Okay, this road accident issue a urban city and rural area that threaten many lives. Therefore, this issue need a various solid prevention measure in terms of safety, road user, vehicle and environment. As a conventional method, speed prevent road traffic accident due to over speed cases. This conventional speed harm stressing impact on human health and also vehicle. Bottom damage, wear, tear, brake, tires, suspension as well, internal component and damage of the vehicle. So that's kind of thing that we're going to see how to reduce damage on this vehicle and also impact to the human health. Okay, due to the traffic related problem arise in the implementation of conventional speed hump, therefore non-Newton speed hump speed will be developed in this project. Right, there are three main objectives to study comparison between speed hump. We're going to compare what is the speed hump using for the traffic calming, and secondly, to investigate the performance efficacy of non-speed hump, and also to develop a non-Newtonic cruise speed hump. Let's go to the literature review. We have a speed hump, speed table, speed cushion here. Speed hump is a parabolic vertical traffic calming device intended to slow down traffic. Okay, it's a raised structure as well. We call it speed hump. Okay, on the other hand, speed table, mid-block traffic calming device that raises the entire wheelbase of the vehicle to reduce the traffic speed. Okay, speed table as well, define a flat top surface, speed hump, even sometimes called a trapezoidal hump or speed platform. Okay, and speed cushion. Entire speed hump or speed table include wheel close to the allowed large vehicle to pass and affected while reducing passing speed hump. Okay, all right. This is another example, the conventional speed hump. We have a speed hump like a zebra crossing. It's a raised pavement structure spanning across the road, which is forcing driver to slow down because it's a hump and a raised pavement. Okay, then we have non-Newtonic fluid speed hump, which is the speed hump itself is made by fluid. Then we have a piston speed hump. Usually to generate some electricity or so on. Then there's some example of previous study by Pooja, Ronald, Zhang, Relativity Express and so on. It's more on how to use this non-Newtonic speed hump to reduce a speed. Alright, there's comparison of other speed hump. Okay, composition speed hump, non-Newtonic fluid speed hump, and air piston mechanic speed hump. Okay, if you see here, conventional is permanent, not sensitive, not sensitive to speed vehicle. Okay, depend on compression and so on, and maintenance is high for speed hump, and there's low maintenance for the Newtonic speed hump, as well as increasing of noise pollution, and for the non-fluid speed hump it will be decreasing. A method that to investigate is to study effect. We can conclude that we're going to have a composition. We're going to check a noise as well as the speed of the vehicle. Okay, this is the same thing, speed reduction. Okay, let's go to methodology. Okay. For objective number one, we're going to have a information gathering, identify the attribute and comparison table. We're going to compare the kind of speed hump. Secondly, we're going to develop a speed hump. Okay, this is a development method, planning of material, design, prototype, and so on. Then we're going to check or to analyze the performance of this speed hump. Let's go to comparison. Okay, this is an information gathering also on. The aim of study to refer source and previous and check what is information where we can get. So this example. Alright, we also go by the parameters, which is natural sensitivity, speed reduction, installation method, and so on, and also installation cost. We need to compare. Then we go to the development of non-speed, development of non-Newtonic fluid speed hump. All right, we do a task planning, material selection, okay, material preparation, designing, prototype, and so on. All right, this is the schedule that we're going to have. We're going to use a cornstarch, polyethylene nucleus, carbon fiber, synthetic rubber sheet. This is very important. The static rubber sheet that can sustain the fluid inside as well as to can restrain the friction between the vehicle to this device. Okay, we're going to prepare a material, design prototype, prepare, and so on. Then expected outcome is something like this. We're going to install this. You're going to have a speed hump, but in the other hand, it make from a fluid that make a smooth ride, but it also will slow down the car, but less noise. Okay, let's check the performance. So you need to have a speed reduction vehicle testing, speed reduction and noise pollution testing. This is planning, the motorcycle, speed reduction. We have, okay, we're going to have use a motorcycle weight 50, 60 and 70. Then we have a radar gun to check the speed. Also as we have a sound level meter, okay, to check the pollution. Okay, this is the viral work. You're going to have a one passenger and additional work to get the weight of 50 kg, 60 kg, 70, and the bike itself is 90 kg. All right, this is how we're going to do. First step, to reduce speed reduction vehicle with various load testing. We're going to test various offloading, and we're going to check what is a speed reduction when it's approaching or passing the speed hump. Okay, this is that we're planning to do a convention with the conventional speed hump, and also the different with the fluid speed hump. This is going a comparison to check the effectiveness or performance of this non-Newtonian fluid speed hump. Alright, let's go to speed reduction test. We have a speed gun and a motorcycle. Again, we're going to use a 10 kilometer per hour, 20, 30, 40, and 50 kilometers per hour. And we're going to let the vehicle passing the speed hump. Okay. Then with the distance as well, different distance before 10, 20, 30, we're going to back. Then we're going to put in this table. So that's how we're going to get the speed reduction, is actually initial speed and minus a stop when it stops speed. Okay. All right, let's go to the last one, noise pollution test. We're going to check the noise. Again, we're going to have a 20, 40, 60 kilometer hours, and we're going to compare with the conventional. All right, passenger speed 20, 40, 60. Then we have a passenger car, motorbike, and we're going to check the noise at the start, the steady stage, also as passing commercial speed hump and also passing a fluid speed hump. Okay, that's the schedule that we need to do. Noise pollution, this is the equipment, expected result. Okay, this is very important. This is what we expect, our hypothesis. Speed reduction of vehicle with various loading. Speed reduction with minimal discomfort from user compared to conventional. This is our hypothesis. When using a fluid speed hump, will be the reduction of speed minimal. So meaning, it still speed, it still move. The speed will only reduce a minimal, just minimal discomfort for the user. Okay. Then we have a speed reduction. We can check the speed reduction, and as well as the noise pollution test, we're going to get a lower noise level from compared to the conventional speed hump. All right, I think that's all from me. Thank you very much for listening to my article, methodology on developing non-Newtonic fluid speed hump. Thank you very much.